Sovereignty and Why Spain is Ultimately Important. February 28, 2019 by Anna Von Reitz. In the great scheme of things, sovereignty is a key idea that people need to understand. In truth, only God is sovereign. All the problems we have in this world go straight back to the Book of Samuel. The confusion arises because we were given free will and people mistake free will for sovereignty. The two things are not the same, and neither is man's sovereignty anything akin to God's sovereignty. Admitting that, let's discuss what passes for sovereignty among men. There is what we call lawful sovereignty, which is what our forefathers touched upon with the concept of natural and unalienable rights. These are the gifts of nature and of nature's God, as Thomas Jefferson put it, the exercise of free will, to be able to think, talk, move about, work, live, and all those other fundamentals we tend to take for granted. Then there is legal sovereignty, which is what goes on with monarchies and governments. This is the sort of sovereignty that Saul received, where people arbitrarily make someone king over them for whatever reason, and subject themselves to the monarch as their leader. In this country, the founders of our government adopted and espoused lawful sovereignty and the concept that mankind was born free and should remain free to believe and live as we see fit, and so long as we cause no harm, the government should not interfere with us. They also found a way for us to enjoy legal sovereignty. That answer came from William the Conqueror and the Norman barons who overcame the monarchy in England by force of arms and whose direct descendants enforced the Magna Carta. Upon his death, William made his senior nobles sovereigns in their own right and bequeathed to them perpetual landed interest that could never be sold or ceded. These men held rank equal to King John, and the only difference between them was that King John was responsible for the care of the poor, via the Commonwealth, and the Church's holdings in England. These men who were kings in their own right were not kings in the public, but in the private realm. They owed and their descendants owe no fealty to anyone but themselves. What William Belcher did in acting as legal sovereign over the American interests in the international jurisdiction was an exact repeat of what William the Conqueror did when he bequeathed sovereignty to William Belcher's ancestors. He made every American born in this country a free sovereign in their own right. This is the source of legal sovereignty in this country. It goes all the way back to the Norman conquest. It is because of this that our homes are our castles and we are not born into subjection to any earthly power. That does not mean that we cannot willingly subject ourselves, and that does not mean that other sovereigns will not attempt to subject us, as the British monarchs have deliberately sought to do in breach of trust and under conditions of fraud now to be addressed. So now that you understand better the concepts of lawful sovereignty and legal sovereignty and the basis for your claim to both, you are ready to comprehend the importance of Spain, a country and a venerable monarchy that most Americans seldom think about. Spain is the keeper of the bulk of the Holy See's assets, most of the gold that the Church has is in three Spanish banks. The Spanish king is the lord of the earth in the same way and in the same system as the British king is lord of the sea. All the land in America was ultimately granted to us by the Spanish king, all the payments and squabbles and wars notwithstanding, it was his to settle ownership interest in the land and soil, which he guaranteed to our ancestors and which remains ours as long as we live and stand as American state citizens. This is why the British usurpers have been at such pains to unlawfully convert our political status records to that of U.S. citizens and to thereby quietly eradicate our natural lawful and legal sovereignty so as to subject us to their queen without a shot being fired, and also acquire our land and soil assets. The Spanish king is an honest man. He knows what has gone on here. And he is still lord of the earth, in that system of things. He is our natural ally in this argument and bound to defend the lawful people against the legal persons, a role that defends the natural order of things and the supremacy of the land and soil in the lives and affairs of men. But he can only act if we also act in our own favor and exercise our own sovereignty and choose to govern ourselves as American state nationals and American state citizens, because it is only in that status and in that capacity that we heirs of our kingdom. Please hit subscribe, like, share, embed, and get ready for many more Anna Von Reitz article videos.